I always say my wife, when my wife was pregnant, I would say, my wife, you know, she's pregnant. And then I always have these people like, excuse me, you're supposed to say we're pregnant? You're supposed to say we're pregnant? It's like, well, I'm not a seahorse. So, I'm not fucking pregnant. My wife is pregnant. Look at her. She's putting on weight. Her feet are swelling up. You know, she's miserable. Fucking miserable. I'm still doing pull-ups. I'm crushing it. While being pregnant, I'm still drinking, smoking. Yeah. I saw a woman a couple months back, professional soccer player, right? She goes on to ESPN or one of these sports channels, and she starts bitching, going like, I don't understand. How come female athletes don't make as much as male professional athletes? Right? And all of these men had to sit there and act like they didn't know what the answer was. They had to sit there like dumbfounded, like, oh, I don't know. Why is that? That is a conundrum. I have no idea. Literally, I'm sitting at home screaming at the TV because you don't sell any fucking tickets. Nobody is going to women's soccer games. You're playing in a 20,000-seat arena. 1,500 people show up. That's not a good night. The promoter lost his fucking ass on that gig.
Does it make you more aggressive?
What?
Elk.
No, Joe, you lunatic. You had to beat the fuck out of people for like 3 decades before you could like chill, smoke a little weed, put on your little rascal's hat, and just fucking chill out.
I know you're not supposed to make fun of fat people. I understand, all right? I don't know why, though. Why? They're not a race. They're not a religion. It's totally curable. Eat an apple and go for a walk, you know? Why are you yelling at everybody else? The fuck are you giving me shit for? All right? You put the cookies in there. I didn't. How is this my problem? Jesus Christ, you ate your way in, you can walk your way out. All right? And just slowly start shedding the pounds. Shove some fucking lettuce in there instead of a bunch of ho-hos, and it's gonna come down, and then you're on my side of the fence, right? Join me. Come on, stay with me. Shame. Shame! Right? Transgender athletes, I don't fucking understand that, you know? I understand it if, you know, you want to switch around. I don't give a shit. But I'm a sports fan. That's a really new concept to me, that you can be a dude, right? Ranked 80th in the fucking world. You have your dick cut off, you put on a sports bra, and now you're the number one tennis player in the world just coming out there with your man shoulders. That doesn't seem fair. I might be wrong. I might just be an old guy. I have no idea. But I'm hearing rumors like some of them are getting into that MMA. You can't have that shit. Am I nuts? That is a dickless dude beating the shit out of a woman. Jesus Christ. He might as well hit her with his discarded dick like a flashlight. Hold still. No, it's grounded. Her grounded pound is incredible. Let's bring him to a nice, normal, mainstream topic so everybody can drive home happy. No fights, all right? Sound good? All right, great. Let's talk abortion. There you go. Pro-choice always made sense to me because I don't like people telling me what to do. And I always just like, it's your body. Who the fuck am I to tell you what to do with your body? So that always made sense. However, I still think you're killing a baby. See? That's where it gets weird. Pro-choice people are like, well, it's not a life yet. It's not a baby yet. May or may not be true. I don't know. I'm not a doctor. But I'll tell you, my gut tells me that doesn't make sense. It's not a baby yet. That would be like if I was making a cake and I poured some batter in a pan and I put it in the oven. And then 5 minutes later, you came by and you grabbed the pan, you threw it across the floor. And I went, what the fuck? You just ruined my birthday cake. And then you were like, well, that wasn't a cake yet. Well, it would have been if you didn't do what you just did. There would have been a cake in 50 minutes. Something happened to that cake, you cake murdering son of a bitch. Right? Oh, I think I know how to raise a kid. You know what it is? You just play catch with them. That's how you raise a kid. You play catch with them. You just talk about life. You distract them by throwing the ball. They don't even notice. You're filling their heads up with your theories. Right? You don't do it the old school way, the way your parents used to. Sit down across from you. You want to tell me about your day? Right? What's that, son? We're not going to church today. Fuck that. That's all a bunch of bullshit. God's everywhere, but I got to go down there to see him. Really?
and he's mad at me down there and I owe you money, go fuck yourself. It's not down, it's in here. They try to take it. It's in here. You do something good, you feel good. You do something bad, you feel bad, you know? Unless you're like a sociopath and you don't feel shit. Unless you got somebody duct taped upside down in your apartment, you know? And if you do something like that, I want you to feel like you can come to me, you know? Yeah, come to me, confess all of that. We'll go down to the precinct, we'll tell them everything. Yeah, I'm gonna turn you in. This isn't fucking Dexter. What are you, mind? Let's have a little empathy here. Put yourself in a lesbian's shoes. Who do lesbians date? Women. Who do they move in with? Women. Who do they get in relationships with? Women. Who do they eventually marry? Women. And I was thinking like, oh my God, I did that. I know what it's like to live with one of those fucking things. I know exactly what that, it's hopeless. Trying to make them happy. Hey, I bought you the shiny thing. Did I do it right? Huh? Trying to get them to take responsibility for their actions. Not gonna happen. The best you're gonna get is I'm sorry, but I know what it's like to be winning a fucking argument. You're winning, and then they turn it around. They're crying. You're apologizing. You're thinking, what the fuck just happened? How am I losing this shit? I had you on the ropes. You feel so dumb. You gotta go for a walk, and you're just thinking, how did I lose again? And then you figure it out. It makes you feel stupid, and then you see some bald idiot with a giant orange mustache, and you're like, you know what? Why don't you take some of that shit?
Oh, I discovered you.
I do owe my whole career to you. Yeah. I was struggling until Bobby Lee discovered me.
Not discover you in terms of like you did it on your own, obviously, but no, in terms of my awareness of you.
Oh.
Can I tell you that story?
Oh, no. I remember it was a big day in my career. Bobby Lee is finally aware of me. Am I on Bobby Lee's radar?
See, this is what he's going
to... This is when things start to happen.
I'm not going to allow this to happen.
Reversal.
I'm not going to allow this to happen.
Reversal.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just going to plug away. You know what I mean?
Listen, you can talk to him all you want. I can hear it. Yeah.
Really? How many siblings do you have?
I don't know, dude. The internet's too fucking weird to give out all that information.
Oh, you don't even want to say really? How many because you're afraid that... It will
by all means, keep
privacy.
Talking about it. Is there any way you can cut this out? I'm honest, dude. Like,
seriously?
Yeah, no, dude. There's fucking lunatics out there.
Okay.
Well.
Off the air, I'll cut it.
All right.
Jeez. I love how surprised he is. Jeez.
Well, you can mention the amount.
Absolutely crazy people. Well,
okay, yeah.
Listen, right. You're one of those guys, you don't need compliments. You actually need to be pulled down a little bit.
Yes, Bill.
To be tethered.
I give myself.
To something. And I would say that it betrays an underlying insecurity, but there isn't with you. You're just full-on fucking ego.
I'm full-on.
Actually, Nerd Jesus died in the last year, right? Steve Jobs. Yeah, he died, right? I know, a lot of nerds here tonight. I know, you're sad. I didn't get the big deal they made about that guy. When he died, they were like, he changed the world. That was insane. He changed the world. The world was one way, and then Steve Jobs came, and it was another. What did he do? Somebody, for the love of God, what the fuck did that guy do? What did he do? He told other people what to invent? I want my entire music collection in that phone. Get on it! Right? And then these poor, nameless, faceless scientists gotta go in a back room and figure it out. How the fuck are we gonna get all of this into this? I mean, what year does this guy think this is? This is crazy. This is like Buck Rogers. Dude, my kid has a birthday in like 11 months. Steve Jobs just walking by. I don't hear any thinking going on in there. Just strutting around the office, eating some pretentious fruit like a pear. Right? just throwing out ideas. Another one I just came up with on the way to work. I was reading a magazine the other day, turning pages, you know? I'd like to turn pages on a screen that aren't even there. Yeah, wrap your fucking heads around that, guys. See you in 8 years. Where you going, Michael? Big, little, get on it. Right? And all these people slave away to make his vision come true. And then they have the big nerd fest, right? Down there, Comic-Con, and all their nerd mecca. They're all showing up with their acne and their Hulk shirts, limping into the arena, right? Does Steve Jobs go out with a whole chorus line of scientists? No, he goes out there by himself. Sneakers and no belt, like it was no biggie, right? Like he's Tesla. Tapping into the atmosphere. I know, this is always uncomfortable. I know, you bought into it, right? That whole advertising, the way they aligned themselves with some of the greatest people of all time. Jesus, Gandhi, me. Remember that? Muhammad Ali, John Lennon, this guy. How the fuck was that dude like any of them? Gandhi didn't have a sweatshop. Nah, he didn't have people leaping to their deaths only to catch a net and get ricocheted back through the window to have to put together yet another iPad. John Lennon didn't have children in his basement pressing those fucking albums. I know. New phone can't fit the old charger. This is your hero? This is the guy? This is what all the silence is about. New phone can't fit the old charger, so then you gotta throw it out, ends up in the ocean around some octopus's neck. Do you realize how much sea life is ecstatic that that man is no longer walking the earth?
Sports is it's a great way to tap out from the news and just, you know, watch a game and get away from it. And now there's like all these causes are getting like attached to it. Like I was watching the World Series, and I'm in the middle of watching the World Series, and out of nowhere they have this moment, stand up to cancer. I'm watching a ball game, and all of a sudden everybody stands up holding up a sign of somebody that they either know that's dying of cancer or died of it in the middle of the game. It's just like, what are you doing? Trying to watch a game here. You know, no, there's a time and a place. Look, I know somebody. I know somebody that has died of cancer. I would never go to the movies with you and in the middle of it hit pause and be like, oh, by the way, Conan, I know this guy. He died of cancer. It was horrific. I could have lifted him up off the sheet with two fingers. It was horrible. Hey, enjoy. Oh, by the way, I got molested when I was 9. Enjoy the rest.
No, I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. I don't know what the fuck is going on. But I think white women started it. It's the worst. The fucking worst. It's all they do is bitch, moan, and complain. I had no idea how difficult it was to be a white woman in the United States of America. Evidently, it's really difficult. Yeah, they're always bitching. Do you have any idea what it's like to be me? Well, I imagine it would be slightly less awesome than my life. What happened to you today, sweetheart, huh? Did they not chill your rosé, you know? Was the trolley not running down at the mall? What happened? No, it's unreal. I'm really fucking annoyed how white women have the fucking balls to throw my white privilege in my face, you know? Start to separate themselves from these white males with their white male privilege. It's like, bitch, you're sitting in the jacuzzi with me. The fuck are you talking about? Yeah, quit your fucking whining. Look. Here's a little caveat here, so you don't think I'm a complete asshole right out of the gate. All right, if you live in some honey boo boo lifestyle on the Appalachian Trail, you know, your uncle just banged you in the dirt. All right.
So your Christian background is part of the show. Or
yes, and
two
I wanted
episodes.
To talk to you about Jesus after this.
Well, the only reason why I bring it up is some people thought maybe you went a little too far, you know.
As far as what?
Well, they thought that maybe you were being disrespectful to the Christian religion.
Who did?
I'm telling you, you need to Google.
Oh, good Lord.
So did you feel you were being disrespectful, or just you were just having fun with some of the crucifixes and stuff like that?
I don't even know what you, I mean, we did maybe two jokes about that.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't you think the Catholic Church went a little too far? More so than my cartoon.
All right, listen.
A couple of jokes. I know this is a morning show. You can't bring up all those crimes.
You know what? Technically.
They just sort of kept moving them around. You know, like those killer whales at SeaWorld, after it kills a trainer, they'll then move it up to Seattle. They don't give them their background.
All right, I'm not totally following, but I don't think
I want
to.
You know what I'm talking about? It's a morning show. I understand.
Like, daytime
came
positive.
On. That kid was missed the graduation, and then it was a feel-good story.
It was a feel-good, and we want to leave.
If you want to feel good about America, you watch the morning shows. You don't watch this, you know.
And
we were joking earlier. If that kid's story about the graduation was late night, that would have been a whole different story.
What do you think?
He's still missing. We can't find him. All we found was his hat. But you watch in the morning. It's great. It all worked out. He got his own personal graduation. Like, I was in such a great mood. Look how yellow this couch is.